After my brother was killed, for years I worked against peace. I was very active in mobilization. I was very active in throwing stones. I was very active in writing. And when I was 18, I decided that I needed to learn Hebrew, even though it was mandatory in my high school and I didn't do it. And when I went to learn Hebrew, it was the first time I sit in a classroom. Everybody around me is Jewish, but we're not soldiers. We're not settlers. And that interaction was so different. And we started over really weird things, have nothing to do with conflict. We started our conversations about music, the fact that I love country music, which is really strange for Palestinians, and I found a couple of people who did. We talked about coffee and which coffee is better, instant coffee or Arabic coffee. But it was from there that the whole demonization of the other was so hard to follow anymore, because we got to see a human being. And next time there was a suicide bombing in Jerusalem, I didn't think of the enemy and suicide bombing against the enemy. I thought of my friends. And I picked up the phone and I started calling to make sure none of them are hurt. Next time there was a problem in East Jerusalem and somebody was shot, all these people in my Hebrew class started calling me and wanting to make sure that I'm fine. And that interaction, that reality, made me come to a point of understanding that we have to bring down those walls that separate us. And if we know each other a little better as a human, we might be able to also love each other instead of kill each other.